Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. And welcome back to Instagram versus reality, where I merge my former life as an editorial and advertising photography graduate who took a keen interest in digital retouching and photo manipulation with my new life as an influencer. And we talk all about, in particular this episode, filters, fillers, Botox, and techniques that are used to basically lie to us, I guess. Before we get into today's episode, filters and fillers, I think I'm gonna call it. As you know, I like to do my skincare routine doing this, so I've already cleansed, really boring cleanse. Don't want to talk about it. I'm doing a morning routine, so I'm going to go back in with a toner. This is the Round Lab Birch Sap Toner. I don't know, it's new and it's all in Korean. I should learn Korean. All product details will be in the description box. So let's talk about FaceApp. If you don't know FaceApp, I believe they're founded in about 2017. And this is basically a photo editing app on crack. Can I say crack? I think we can say crack. So FaceApp describes themselves, looking at their website, as one of the most popular apps around the world that uses AI filters, tools, and effects to turn portraits into magazine covers in one tap. And it's true. It's crazy. The changes you can make to your skin within seconds. So apparently it does this by using neural networks based on artificial intelligence. I have no idea what that means, but it sounds both equally fascinating and terrifying all at the same time. Another layer of toner, because why not? This is so nicely hydrating. It's that typical full fat toner water that we love. Get that everywhere. Pat, 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 pat. I pat not because it's better than rubbing, but because my skin is very reactive. It can go quite red at like a single touch. This app can make you look younger, can make you look older, change your hair color, change your sex. Facial features in the most subtle or obvious way, depending on how much of the filter you use. FaceApp once again has had a sudden boom, but it was really popular back in 2019, partly due to some viral tweets that we can see here showing actors in films and some old-fashioned memes having these drastic makeovers. As I mentioned, due to its AI intelligence, scary robots are taking over. This app sets itself apart from the likes of Facetune, Photoshop, whatever else you use, Snow, because it can give you what looks like hours worth of work in Photoshop in seconds. Let's stop talking about it. Let's have a look at some examples. So actually, I posted a before and after of myself on Instagram to show the subtle yet obvious differences that the app can make. And the majority of feedback I got was from people saying they didn't notice the difference. Then when I put them side by side, people were like, had you not put them side by side, I would have no idea that you edited this picture in any way. And that's what's fascinating to me as like a photography graduate, that I'm like, oh my God, like, as if an app can do this, as if an app can pretty much do what took me years to learn in a single click. As an influencer, this terrifies me because it's making me second guess, I guess, everyone's selfies, everyone's sponsored work. This probably has one of the best kind of like skin filters as well that I've ever seen. Texture's still there. There's some kind of tonal differences as well, but it looks pretty much perfect and seamless. It's terrifying. So let's take a look at these before and afters via TikTok. For those who haven't seen it, this gives you a really good of how subtle you can go with this app and how extreme you can go with this app. It's getting harder and harder to clock what's been edited and what hasn't. The hair isn't perfect. You can see like when her fingernails was on her hair that they were kind of like just disappearing. But if your hands aren't in the shot, it's pretty seamless. It's terrifying. Let's look at the next video.
If you ever wondered why your Instagram pictures don't tend to turn out like everyone else's, or why when someone takes a picture of you it doesn't look like the perfectly polished stuff we see on Instagram, here is an app called FaceApp, and I'm going to show you how all the influencers are editing the pictures. So as you can see, I've just completely changed, well, not changed my face, but like very much enhanced my face. I'm now able to somehow add volume to my hair. I don't know how this works. The weird thing is, I actually loved this picture of me before, but now that I've done this to myself, I don't like the original picture anymore. which just tells you everything you need to know about how bad editing yourself is for your brain, let alone the people who follow you. Look at the difference. If you ever wonder why your pictures don't turn out like an influencer's, this is why. What?
And that's the thing. That's the thing is, like, the pictures that a lot of people strive to look like aren't real. And we know that. We know that. But this is just showing how incredibly easy it is to do. Like, people don't even need to get ready for the picture anymore. You could turn up like this. And that app will give you your makeup, however natural or full on as you like, volume in your hair. There's whole hairstyles on there. And that's another point she makes, a good point, that when you first take a selfie, that, you know, there's nothing wrong with the picture. Then you start editing it. Then you get in your head all these things like, oh, maybe my face should look like that. Maybe my skin does look better this way. And you start to make these like awful, awful changes that you now feel like you have to live up to. Okay, so this one shows probably the most popular filter on here, the influencer filter, which is the Hollywood filter. And this girl's gonna apply it 10 times. And again, I think this is a good idea of showing you how subtle or how crazy you can go with this. And as you can see, she looked, by the end of it, she looked like every single influencer on Instagram. She looked like every single beauty, fashion, the same makeup. And that's the thing. I think the thing with this app getting popular is you're going to start recognizing makeup looks as the Face app makeup look. You know what I mean? Or you're going to start noticing these little styles that the Face app gives you. And you're going to be able to clock these. I feel like this isn't going to be the be-all and end-all of like retouching apps, you know. Of course, apps like this don't come without controversies, and other than the FBI actually issuing security concerns, there were some questionable and, in my opinion, pretty racist filters on the early days of this app. One of these awful filters goes as far back as 2017, when they had a filter named Hot. And this single app filter supposedly made the user more attractive. However, the changes that were made to make the subject more attractive was the lightening of skin and basically making everyone's features more European. We're talking blue eyes, slimmer nose, etc., etc. Of course, this was called out by users as pretty much being racist, because it is. So they quickly renamed the filter to Spark. However, the filter was later taken down completely, and rightfully so. But wait, it actually gets worse. Unbelievably worse. In August of the same year, they launched new ethnicity filters, where you could change your race to, and I quote, white, black, Asian, and Indian. These filters went viral for all the wrong reasons. Basically, they depicted stereotypical and racist features of people of color, black people, and of course the filters were again rightfully removed, and maybe someone got fired for basically inventing digital blackface. I don't know, who knows. So we do have to consider who is using these. It's not just influencers, it's also younger children, and this is where it really starts to take issue for me, because I didn't grow up with stuff like this. I wasn't comparing myself to myself at that age, a fake version of myself. But there are these groups who are advocating for these apps to be only available to people 16 years plus, to kind of line up with what social media, how old you have to have a social media account, an Instagram account, etc. Also, alongside a new social media literacy training, meaning let's teach these kids how this is done, what's going on, why it's done, rather than thinking these images are real. Which is great. I think the school system needs to catch up with modern day life, basically. Teach kids how to do taxes, for God's sake. But also, influencers are using these apps, obviously. They could be using these apps in the lower settings, and no one's even noticing, meaning they could be skirting around the issue of not retouching their pictures for sponsored and paid for work. So the real deeper issues with these photo editing apps is, of course, you have to question the mental health aspect of them. How does it make people feel seeing a better and hotter version of themselves? Like shit, most probably. And we've touched on that a lot, and a lot of people touched on that. It's a very, very important conversation, which I hope to talk about in a lot more detail early this coming year. A few interviews, get some facts and figures going on there. I kind of want to shift the conversation a little bit. Related, but slightly shifted. Back in 2018, we kind of saw the rise of Snapchat dysmorphia, it was being called. And this is basically teens and people in their 20s wanting cosmetic procedures and tweakments in order to look like a filtered version of themselves. Now, we're not talking like dog nose and bunny ears. We're talking about slimmer noses, more chiseled jaw and cheeks. And this has basically carried through into today, with Snapchat and Instagram filters being used pretty much as default by anyone posting an Instagram story. And of course, Face App Today. Now, according to Dr. Vashi, director of the Boston University Cosmetic and Laser Center, patients aren't bringing in pictures of celebrities as cosmetic inspiration anymore. They are bringing in photoshopped and edited pictures of themselves, a version of themselves that doesn't exist, but what they want to look like. With the most popular treatments apparently being cheekbone contouring, straightening or reducing nose size, cheek and chin fillers, and fat melting injections. With a staggering 55% of patients saying that they want these tweakments to look better in selfies and on Zoom calls. Not in real life, online. They want to look better online. What? And of course, with Zoom being the most popular form of communication last year, well, this year and the year before, once everything started to reopen, clinics have just seen a boom in bookings for these kind of like lunchtime tweakments. So I'm gonna go in quickly with the AESTURA Atobarrier Hydro Essence. This is basically a skin barrier repairing essence. My redness isn't too bad today. So that's the main concern here, is people are wanting to look better online, where they post the majority of their pictures, seek the most attention and reassurance and validation, but not in real life. So let's talk about fillers. I have no issue with them. I get them. I actually get filler in my nose. You can see I'm kind of due. I actually have like a bump in my nose here, and I get filler to even it out. I get filler in the tip of my nose to add a tip onto the end. I've had cheek filler before. I get chin filler sometimes, depending on how I feel at the time. And I get Botox as well. And I feel like we need to talk about fillers, because I know there's this idea that everyone's like, love who you are, let's stop doing fillers. But the difference between filters and fillers and the way you look is that fillers are attainable. You can go and get it done in your lunch, and it's takes like 15 minutes, if that. And it's a cosmetic procedure that isn't going anywhere. And whenever I discuss this, it's really interesting, because the feedback I always get is very 50-50. People seem to love them or like enjoy them and get them done. Used to hate them, have them now, loves it. Or people hate it and they want to embrace their natural beauty, which is fine. Either one is fine. No one come for each other in the comments. So first of all, let's discuss the difference between filters and filler. So according to the first page of Google, Botox freezes muscles to stop creases and wrinkles caused by facial expressions. So look, I used to have a line here. My forehead is very, you see? My partner hates it when I do this. Fillers use hyaluronic acid and similar substances to fill in or plump up areas that have lost volume and smoothness, and sometimes to reshape. So fill up the gap in here, for example, reshape the tip of the nose, reshape this and chin. I haven't had that done for a while, so I'll be getting that done again in January. I personally, we'll talk about it in a minute, but I personally like to be open about what I get done. So with this in mind, are fillers just semi-permanent filters? Kind of. And in my personal opinion, I do think influencers should be open about what they've have done, depending on what they do, if it affects the products they're talking about and the sponsorships that they get. But there is nuance here, so it's difficult because neither have effect on the condition of your skin. I get some comments about my filler and my Botox saying, why should we trust your skincare if you get these done? Because they don't lighten dark spots. They don't even out my skin tone. I won't talk about anti-aging products because I get Botox. I do believe, however, people with lip filler shouldn't be able to advertise the effects of lip balms, plumpers. People who get injectable hydration shouldn't say how well a product hydrates their skin. You know, it's kind of a gray area and lots of, but what if this and what if that, but you know, if they do that, it's a lot of like ifs and buts. On that sense as well, should celebrities have to disclaim what they've had done? No, not if, in my opinion, no, not if it's got nothing to do with what they do. If they are trying to sell us a lip kit where they say that overlining your lips makes them look bigger, yet they've had lip injections, lip filler, then yes, I think that's lying. I think that's misleading. That's not right. If they're doing a skincare line and they get daily facials, they see a dermatologist, then yeah, I think be open about your skincare journey for sure. But honestly, if they aren't selling us something that claims to change the way our skin or our body looks, then it's really none of our business and we can probably tell anyway. What I feel is important here is to educate people in what is possible, what is being done, and how common it is. What alterations can people have? So we can look at these celebrities and influencers and stop comparing ourselves to someone who is probably 50% filler. No judgment. I love filler. Fill yourself up. However, there are reasons as well that people have Botox and filler that doesn't affect their appearance, or does affect their appearance, but it was done for medical reasons. We are talking extreme migraines, excessive sweating, spasms, trouble breathing properly, acne scarring. So many of these I would deem personal, and of course, I don't think people have to disclaim this. So I want to take a look at some Botox and fillers before and after from subscribers and social media friends I have, because I think we have this very set idea of what Botox and filler is. We have this idea that it's huge lips, like, you know, these crazy cheeks and crazy, like, facelift kind of faces, rather than subtle changes and little tweaks that it's made for. So we were sent a video from Kirsty, who's shown us her Botox. I love this. It's very similar to mine. There's still much movement and, you know, able to make expressions. Her face isn't frozen solid. You know, we still have, the like, these, like, lines and stuff here, but that's what you want. You don't want your face to look completely frozen. You still want to be able to, you know, move your eyebrows a little bit. We have a before and after lip filler here, which I love as well. Nothing crazy, it's just natural looking. They don't look hard, they don't look overly pouty. And then we have some chin filler here as well. I love this girl's chin before, but it's personal, you know? And we'll talk about this in a minute. What is the difference, in my personal opinion, from having filler to using heavy filters and trying to change the way you look? Whoever's done this has done it so nicely and so well. This is also a great example. This is what I have done. It's like a little bit of filler here to change that kind of like hook and dip in the nose. Looks great, very natural, nothing crazy going on here. And some lip filler from one of my favorite skincare educators on Instagram here as well. Again, very natural. It really, really balances out her face. I love it. Then we have a Botox before and after from Thomas. Again, a great skincare content creator here, over on Instagram actually. Really nice, natural look, nothing crazy. We have some Botox before and afters from Lab Muffin, Michelle from Lab Muffin, a 3.5 week review. And here we can see a before and after picture. And Michelle basically had jaw slimming, and this is just kind of like round out her jawline. And it looks great. Again, very, very supernatural. Not supernatural, but like supernatural looking. Michelle also mentions that she grinds her teeth a lot in her sleep as well. So this has actually built up muscle in her jaw. And I think she had, I don't know if it's Botox or what, but she has something to relax the muscles in her jaw, so they basically calm down over time and stop building up and getting ripped, basically. The Glow Scout, one of my favorite creators over on TikTok, actually sent me a picture of a Botox lip flip. So this is different. I believe it's different to filler, because instead of filling up, it kind of relaxes the inside. So like the inside comes out? I don't know. But look how nice and subtle this is. It adds that volume to the top lip without being crazy, kind of like duck face. So what are my thoughts on fillers, and why do I get them done? Yet I sit here and preach about not changing our appearance using filters. Fillers for me were a chance to change the appearance of something I really didn't like on my face and still don't like. And me growing up, it wasn't due to social media. No one ever picked on me about it. It was mentioned. People would describe the shape of my nose, but wouldn't bully me about it. And it was always something I was self-conscious about. It was the fact that it looked different to one side compared to the other. It's the fact that my face looked different one side compared to the other because of my nose. As someone, I guess, who was just generally creative and artsy, when I didn't see symmetry, I was like, oh my god, you know, the beauty standard of symmetry. I was like, I need to change this. However, I didn't start making these changes until, one, I was fully grown. My first filler was when I was 30. Two, I learned to live with it and kind of like appreciate it. And three, I had the income to do this on a regular basis. The big difference is, however, I didn't grow up on social media. I didn't grow up comparing myself to these people who get filler and Botox constantly. What is that? These influencers who, like a vast majority of the time, have probably already altered their appearance through fillers or even filters. And I am truly spit about this, because I know I'm so much happier with that little bit of hyaluronic acid in my nose. And what's the harm in making these little changes, these subtle changes that people don't even notice, but you do, if it makes you happy? I think personally, if I didn't review skincare, no one would even know. If I didn't talk about it, no one would even know. And when people say to just love yourself, it's one of the most annoying things I think I've ever heard. It's like when people with depression are told to just cheer up. What's the process to cheering up? What is the process to learning to love yourself? Where is the progress in that? As you know, with filters and fillers, my issue is never with the fact that they are being done and the fact that people are using them. My issue is the hush-hush side of it all. I want someone to look at my nose and know that it's not real. No, it's real. Like, it's all there. It's just had stuff done to it. I want people to know that that is what people are able to do. The same with filters. I want people to know what is available and what is out there. We are in the beauty industry. Let's talk about what is available, what is being done. Fillers and Botox aren't going anywhere. They're just getting more and more popular. So we need to educate on what is being done, show good examples of what is being done. And most importantly, talk about the safety, because people are popping up doing fillers everywhere. You can go and get some extensions done and have lip filler done at the same time. I've heard cases where people went on a 1-day training course on how to do fillers and were injecting by the next day. So I think it's important to educate with everything, educate about what is possible. I had an amazing talk with the Lovely Clinic, which I think the card, whatever side it's on, I'll post here, where they talked all about the pros and cons of fillers, the dangers, the potential dangers, although rare, that can come from having filler, especially in the nose. So please go and watch that if you're interested in getting filler or just want to educate yourself. We've all seen those horror stories of exploding lips, paralyzed faces, and even blindness through fillers, and that's usually from people who went to the wrong person. So reach out to your favorite influencer if they're open about their fillers, see where they went, talk to doctors, speak to dermatologists who do fillers. I guess what I feel the main difference between fillers and filters are is you look how you look with fillers. That's you in real life. That's how you appear in person. With filters, that's not how you look. Either way, I don't care. If your job is about the way you look, I think you should be open about what you've had done. It's personal, but don't go selling things that claim to do what your fillers and Botox did for you. You know what I mean? Okay, let's finish on some fun videos just to look at. So one video that was really kind of controversial in my last video was of the TikTok user. Oh, I can't find her username. I'll put it here. But basically, people refuse to believe she was the same person. If you scroll back through her TikTok, you can see that she is the same person, but what she now does is tries to drastically change the way she looks in her before versus her after, because it got views, it got clicks, and rightfully so. I think it's really clever. So I just want to show you this video of her.
Even if you are not ready for the day, it cannot always be night.
But as you can see, her before wasn't as drastic as she made it before. But still, I think like a really, really cool TikTok. What? Sounds so old. Cool TikTok. We actually have this lady who was actually on my management, the same management as me. I didn't realize, but she posts these amazing videos, proof that social media is fake. And I think this might be through the Face app. See, it just shows you how drastic you can go with it. This app can get rid of texture so easily and seamlessly as well. And then we have this picture of Lindsay Lohan where people think she did face app herself. This is basically what Lindsay Lohan posted about her new Christmas film, which I'm so glad she's back to acting, versus what Netflix posted. She looks amazing in both of them. Quick moisturizer. I'm going to use the Glow Recipe Watermelon Pink Juice Moisturizer. But that's the thing with this picture. If you look at it, if they weren't side by side, I wouldn't even notice they were different pictures, like that they had anything done to them. I would just think it's the same picture. But side by side, you can see how it's really drastically evened out her skin tone. Fine lines appear smoother. I skipped a serum today because I just wanted to use this essence, the skin barrier repair stuff. Then I'm going to go in with my Round Lab SPF 50 plus PA 4 pluses. So I'd love to know what you think. I do think fillers is kind of like a gray area because, you know, one side of the argument, you can say, well, what's the difference? You know, we should be encouraging people to embrace the way they look and be happy with the way they look rather than getting these treatments done. I've seen people who love fillers, and it's like, if why not? If I can change something I dislike about my face and then live happily and confidently, also why not? Which I think is also a very valid argument. Let me know in the comments down below. But yes, you can watch the whole Instagram versus reality playlist here and some general light entertainment here. And I'll see you over there. Bye.